So let's talk about your family life. Let's talk about the beautiful babies.
Thank you.
You know what I'm saying? Bash, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then we have your new baby.
Slash. Yes.
So you have Bash.
And Slash. Yes. My boys. Yes.
So how old is Bash?
Sebastian will be 7
okay.
February 21st.
Beautiful baby.
So he's about to be 7.
Love the
I
hair.
I see you're a beautiful baby.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. Yeah, that's DJ.
So cute.
And Tobias is backstage.
Oh.
Yeah, we
yes,
want him
yes.
to be crying all
that.
No, and how old is your new baby? Your newborn?
You just turned 4 months.
So you already at work?
Yes, girl.
You getting to it.
Yes.
But luckily you in LA, so that's
But you're my first, like, back to work.
Oh,
I
no.
came here first.
Okay, shout out to KC. Yes. 101 with Keyshia Cole. No, thank you for coming. I really do
for
appreciate
sure. anytime,
that.
Anytime.
Yeah, and I want, you know, we got to talk about the tattoo. It's everywhere.
I know.
And I wanted to use
Why
that. Right, they tripping, you know what I'm saying? And then, so you
that
have, you have the baby. You have what? Bash and Slash.
Yeah.
And then Kay, what's his name? Your child's father.
Wiz?
No.
Oh, A-E.
A-E.
Yes.
He has the date.
Of Sebastian, that is my ex-husband's son. So I have two baby daddies.
What? Wait.
Yeah.
Hold on. So KD.
No, AE.
AE.
You could just call him Alexander.
Alexander. Okay.
Yes.
So Alexander has the dates.
Yes, of Slash and Bash.
That's so touching, though.
Yeah, but he loves Bash as if Bash was his own, you know? And Bash is really lucky because he has a very present father and a very present stepfather as well.
Oh, look at you all
so,
blessed.
Yeah.
That's a blessing.
It is. And they both coach his baseball team together. They do. We're one big happy family.
She said they do. No, Amber just gangsta. Okay, so y'all went at the same time? Y'all went and got the tattoos at the same time?
No, he got his first.
Oh.
Yeah, he got his probably like 2 months ago. And then I got mine like last week.
What made you do it?
You know, I gotta be honest, like, and I don't want this to sound like corny or anything, but like kind of after Kobe died, mm-hmm. it made me like reflect on my life. And I don't want people to be like, oh, Kobe died and you went and got a tattoo. But it was kind of like that because, you know, I thought about my dad and like my dad had cancer when he was 40. And he went through remission and he's good, but he almost died. Like, and I'm 36. And I was like, I've been wanting this tattoo for a long time. And I was like, you know what? Life is so short. Just do it. Just live your best life. Like,
Just do it.
It's just like, with no regrets, just
Nothing
do it.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that.
That's just how I felt. And I'm happy I did it.
And if he wanted to do it, if he did it and you were there and in support and just loving, you know, your guy, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying? And saying, we got them both, baby.
Well, he encouraged it. He was just like, baby, get it. You got to get it.
But you know what? The truth, yeah. It ain't nothing that's changing in your face because you're just so beautiful.
Thank
like,
you.
Right under there, I could just like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's just so beautiful.
Thank you.
Diamond shining and everything.
Too.
I left mine at home. I'm so mad. No, but it's all good. So mm-hmm. so you got the tattoo and everybody can't stop talking about it, raving about it. Does it make you feel a way that everybody is
Girl,
looking at it so negatively?
I've been through worse scrutiny than the tattoo. Like, I sleep like a baby at night. I can't.
Okay.
It's like, I've been through worse shit. I'm sorry.
It don't even
it's
matter.
Like,
so what's up with the slut walk? What's going on with this now?
So, thank you. So, I'm working on Slut Walk now. We usually have it every October. This past October, I had my son, so I canceled it. Mm-hmm. I was just sick and, you know. But I think I'm going to do it in Miami this year instead of L.A.
Okay.
Just because they have bigger open spaces. We kind of reached capacity very early in the day because there's not a lot of big spaces in L.A.
Okay.
And basically, we march and we walk against rape culture, sexual violence, body shaming, victim blaming. And then we walk into, like, a festival setting, and then we just celebrate women for the rest of the day.
So do you have performances?
Yes.
Yeah. So do you have performances? Like, what is this? If I wanted to go to a slut walk, what could I expect?
We have a lot of performances. We've had Trina perform. We had your friend OT Genesis perform.
Stop. You're petty.
yeah, and
you just feel it. It just brings so much stress around my body. I just be like,
yeah, and my boy Tyga said that he would perform this year.
Oh, nice, nice.
So
nice.
I'm excited about that.
Nice, nice. Shout out to Tyga because he wrote on my last album.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying. Yeah. No, so that's super dope. So we got the Slut Walk thing out the way. You have a book that I didn't know about.
I do have a book.
Okay.
Yeah, How to Be a Bad Bitch.
And then so they told me, oops, I dropped my cards. So they told me that the second book is coming out soon.
I am working on a second book.
How to Be a Bad Bitch.
Mom edition.
Speeding me to juiciness.
But I will be honest, I don't have a book deal yet. So,
oh, well, that's okay. It's coming.
But I get one.
Yeah.
I ain't worried about
it's
it.
It's easy.
Yeah.
It's easy work right there. So what is the How to Be a Bad Bitch Mom edition going to be about?
I would say basically everything. You're on your second baby. You learn so much from your first baby. You know, certain techniques and formulas. And then as they get older and, you know, my son, I mean, this boy asked me some questions.
Sebastian,
Bash. Yes. Yeah, he comes home from school and he asked me a lot of questions.
Wait, at six?
Yes, girl.
What did he say?
I don't even know if I can say it. I mean, these kids talk. Like, can I curse on this?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Well, he don't curse, do he?
Oh, my baby curses.
No!
He does.
Get out of here,
he
Amber.
Does.
But you be pop locking and dropping it.
I do. But you know what? This is the thing. Every parent is different.
This is true.
I let Sebastian express himself. If I feel like he's just cursing for no reason, I'm going to be like, stop doing that. You don't need to be cursing for no reason. But, you know, if he stubs his toe and he says, fuck, I'm not going to get mad at him. You know, he's excelling at school.
Sebastian.
He's doing great at school. I mean, he's a good boy. He knows how to separate school and home life. You know, he doesn't go to school and act out. He's a good boy. So
no, Auntie Keyshia going to whoop him. Your booty.
I reward him by letting him curse.
Auntie Keyshia taking the snacks away.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And also co-parenting. I want to talk about my new book as well, co-parenting. You know.
Why are you looking like that? What?
It's just, you know, I don't want to give away a lot of the book and what I have in my head, but,
yeah,
you
that's
know,
true.
It
that's
is,
true.
It is, it was difficult in the beginning, and I just figured out a way to just make it seamless.
That's good.
Yeah, and so I want to help other people do that.
Well, yeah, I got some co-parenting things going down, too.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm happy that you guys are working that out and that, you know, everybody's getting along. Because ultimately, if, you know, no double backing is happening at all, but, you know, everybody should get along for the children.
Right, for sure.
Yeah, we're all, ultimately, you know, every day, this is our family moving forward.
Right.
Even with the, you know, whatever the girlfriend is or whatever that vibe is, you know, for your other baby's father. I mean, hey.
Yeah, I'm very close. I mean, I wouldn't say I'm very close with his girlfriend, but I have her phone number. I can contact her anytime if I know she's with my son.
Of course.
She's a really nice girl. Sebastian comes home from his dad's house and says how nice she is, and they play with water guns and they play tag and stuff like that. I mean, as a mother, I would much rather a nice woman being around my son than a woman that's mean to my baby.
Yeah.
You know, so.
Yeah, and somebody that you're actually getting along with.
Right.
You know, I mean, I ain't got to sleep with your girl or your guy every night. You
right.
know what I mean?
Exactly.
But on both ends of the spectrum, it should be a situation where I want you to be around my kid and be nice to my child, you know what I mean? And
right.
respectful to my child and things like that, because we don't want to have to fight.
Right.
You
we
know,
don't want to have
to
fight.
We don't want to have to bring out
the,
that
the
side.
Oakland and Philly.
You know what I mean? Because it's just unnecessary.
It is.
And it's just like, you know, I agree with you, and I think that you should release a book that would help educate, because a lot of people don't believe in it, you know. No disrespect to Russell and, you know, Kimora and how he always get along and always on the boat with Kimora.
We're in the boat, right? Yeah, always on the boat.
I'm like, where the hell? Why are you on the boat? But, you know, I mean, his kid's on the boat. You know what I mean? And it's like, hey, you know, we all on the boat. You know what I'm saying? I agree with that. But my boyfriend doesn't really. He's more so like, I don't get none of this. What the hell's going on here? You know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, everybody's different. Yeah. You know, I would say that, like, Alex and Wiz really do get along. I mean, they actually went to the club together not that long ago.
Now, that's just dragging
the
shit.
I was pregnant.
Now.
They went out. I was like,
wait a minute. Wait
go
a minute.
Out and have fun, y'all.
Wait, what? Wait. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about that. Y'all talking about
me? I mean, you got to think that.
What y'all saying? Yeah,
no,
man, she
good.
Be tripping out on you, too. Yeah, man, it just be. And look at my, he too cool for school. He just sitting over there. He ain't trying to hear nothing. Yeah, he ain't trying to hear none of it. No, but that's super dope, though. I mean, I just think that might be a little too far, though, Amber.
I'm not mad at it. I'd rather keep the peace than, like, you know what I'm saying? I'm good with it.
Okay, that's good. That's good. What else you got going on? What else you working on?
Well, like I said, I'm just now getting back to work. I had hyperemesis when I was pregnant. So that basically means, like, it feels like you have food poisoning every day for a year.
Oh, no.
Like, it's not, like, just morning sickness, and then you're okay, like, throughout the day. It was terrible. Like,
I heard you say that online, I believe. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, so it was just like, you know, I'm just now, like, getting back, out, feeling good, you know, and getting back to work. So we'll see. I just signed with a new management company, new agency. Like, I'm just ready to just start over.
So you're going to do fashion?
No.
You're not into it at all?
Never been. That's the
what about your hair color? I tried to get my hair like yours on this show, girl. I had to change it real quick.
You got to shave it off to do that.
I know, but it still didn't work, Amber.
It didn't turn orange.
It didn't work.
Yeah.
I'm like, it just fell out. It just fell out completely.
Yeah, if I grew my hair out and bleached it, it would fall out too.
Yeah.
I can only get this color because it's so
ball,
short.
Ball.
Yeah. Facts.
Wow. Everybody ain't got the face, Amber.
You want me to pick up your... Let me pick these up for you.
No, it's okay.
I got you,
Amber,
sis.
Amber Rose.
Okay, here you go.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you. So you're not gonna... What about hair products? What about the jewelry line?
I'm not mad at jewelry. Okay. I'm not mad at that. I'm not mad at jewelry. I don't know. Fashion never really been my thing. I think that people always look to me as, like, a fashionista.
I do.
It's not really me, though. I just like what
So the whole thing, Kanye just dressed you all up and it was just...
Yep.
Wait.
Basically.
Seriously?
Yeah, I'm just like, I like Jordans and, like, sweatsuits and shit.
With the little pouchy thing. You had the little white pouch with the jean outfit.
Yeah, but I mean, those are things that I liked.
In
but
Paris.
It wasn't like, oh, this just came out. I need it because people think it's cool.
Okay.
I'll want to get something because I just like it.
Okay.
You know, well, I'm not, good. I won't just follow what everybody's
trends
doing.
Trends and stuff like that. You ain't into that. But you can create them, though.
Facts.
Yep. I'm into that. I think Amber needs a fashion line. I think she needs a fashion line.
Because
the girls would like, they'd love it. You know what I mean?
I might work on some things.
But you have an app. Before we get into this app, I want to talk about how you and Kim actually came. Like, y'all got cool. Like, that was shocking to me.
Who?
You and Kim Kardashian.
Who got cool?
Y'all like, you was like, y'all got into it.
Joe, where's...
Babe is up there. Oh. I thought he was...
What? That's my assistant. I know his laugh from a mile away.
No, y'all did. I thought y'all had got into it online, and then it was like, you know, you said something like, you know what I'm saying? Like, don't go too far, because I tell the situations, it's just real. So, and then you was like,
Keyshia, long ago.
I know, but it was just like, to me, it was just shocking. I mean, it's just like how your personality.
I mean, I don't think that we're not cool. I wouldn't say that we're friends. We're not, you know, we don't hang out. We don't talk. We don't, you know. Run in the same circles, but
I just
wish everybody love and success and happiness.
That's what I'm liking.
Yeah.
That's what I feel.
Yeah.
I feel that from you. I feel very like it's just like an easygoing thing. Is that your attitude overall? I mean, how
Always.
Does that? Yeah.
Always.
That's good. How do you stay that way? Like, how do you, in the midst of all this chaotic stuff that goes on the internet and all of this judgmental stuff?
I'm gonna tell you, I grew up very, very poor in Philly. And I was on the other side for a long time. Mm-hmm. So I remember when TMZ came out and Paris Hilton was everywhere. And I used to be like, now, child, she knows she shouldn't be wearing that outfit. She got too much money to be wearing it. And I would be one of those spectators that would talk shit, you know, because I was broke and I just didn't have it. Like, you know,
because I was
and you know, and I was just biased because it was just, I would just sit there and critique. And if Instagram was out during that time, maybe I would have been one of those people to leave a comment. I don't know. See. You know, so when I look at comments like that, I'm like, I'm not mad at you. I understand. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't really fight with people.
I'm not mad. You're mad.
And that's fine. And God bless them.
Okay.
You know?
I like that attitude.
Yeah.
Shout out to you for that because, yeah, you know, we got to keep that good attitude. I feel the same way. I feel the same way. Mm-hmm. Are you married?
Legally, no, I'm not married, but I would say that I am married in the eyes of God.
In the eyes of the beholder.
Yes. I just believe, you know, I believe that Alex is my soulmate, and we have a baby together, and we live together, and we're very happy together, and I don't think that I need paperwork to say that, like, we're married. Like,
you
I
introduce
married? Him as my husband. I don't know. I mean, like, if he proposed to me, I wouldn't say no, but I was already married, Keyshia, and you know, it's like, marriage ain't gonna make nothing better or worse. It's just gonna be a piece of paper you sign, and then that's it. It's like, I'm not worried about that. I just want happiness and stability. All that paperwork and shit is not
really. I feel you. Come on, clap it up for Amber for that. This is the truth. You gotta be happy first. You gotta be real good friends first. You gotta like the person that you're with, and you're loving this person, but you also like them. Not, I have to be with you because we signed these papers.
Right.
We have this kid together, and we have to be together. Nothing has to happen.
Right.
You don't have to be with anybody. You know what I mean? I can leave at any moment.
Yeah.
So we have to work on being friends and loving each other.
Right.
And really being happy with one another. So I feel you on that. I feel you on that. So the whole, okay, so you met, okay, what's his name again? I'm sorry.
Alexander.
Alexander. So he is Tyga's
best friend.
Best friend.
Yeah.
Okay, I met him once in the studio, and Tyga did a song for my last album. It was a Tupac sample.
We listened to it on the way here.
Yeah? He wrote some of it.
Yeah, he's a great songwriter.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Like, I really didn't know that. I didn't even know Tyga wrote like that.
Yeah.
So that was surprising to me.
Yeah, Alex is very, very talented. He's very low-key. He loves to just be in the studio and write hits. That's what he does.
And is he a president over there? Is he A&R over there at Def Jam? I didn't know about that.
Yeah, vice president, yeah.
Okay, yeah, because my nanny is Tyga's cousin. So that is just, yeah. So
one big happy family.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? The family vibe just lit. No, so what's, because they said, I got two things to ask you. I want to know about what does it feel like to know that your exes think that you're the coolest ex to have?
Who said that?
That's what they said. That's what they said. That's what
I want to know.
You the coolest ex, Amber.
I appreciate that.
Are you cool in the relationship? Like, you real chill and hang out and...
I'm not a weirdo. Yeah. I don't do weirdo shit. I don't, like... I give 150%, and if you don't appreciate it, then, you know, I'm out, but I'm never petty afterwards. I don't call other girls. I don't go into DM if, like, they're dating someone new and be like, girl, you don't know about him. I let it go.
Okay.
And I'm just cool.
So 21 Savage said you was the coolest ex.
That's nice.
Right. I'm like, how is them the coolest ex and you think that? How you think that? When we got into it and everything.
I think I'm a very cool ex. I think I'm a cool girlfriend.
That's what I'm saying.
I think I'm just cool.
Yeah, you are just cool. You are just cool. Yeah, they're being shady with that one. So you're great. So, no, they're like, wait a minute now. Y'all being shady with y'all trying to get me to be shady with Amber. That's it. Because I remember, my recollection is that y'all had got into it and it was a vibe and he didn't want to come back and you didn't want to come back. So I didn't know.
No, that is not true.
Oh.
So this is the thing. When I wrote something nice about him, because I like to leave a situation amicably.
Yeah.
So I don't like to leave. I like to be like, you know, I once loved you. Your kids are amazing. You know, no love lost. I like to leave like that. I don't like to be on the internet. And people are like, oh, she's begging him to come back. It was just more so like, let's just leave peacefully. I'll be the bigger person because I don't want to fight with you online. I'm too grown for that. I got...
Correct.
I had one kid at the time, you know? And so, yeah, I just wanted to move forward and I wanted to just... I'm a Libra. I like to smooth things over. That's just who I am, you know?
I feel you on that. I'm feeling you on that. I think I might be too nice, too.
Yeah. Too nice.
Yeah,
for real.
Because, yeah, no. If somebody's being like, yeah, you know, after I leave, it ain't no coming back. And it's like,
right.
Oh,
right.
Well, God bless. Yeah. No, right. I feel you on that. I feel you on that. That's shady, though. They shady.
Yeah, y'all shady.
Get them. No, I'm going to get them in that room. They doing that, Amber, not me.
No, I always answer a question, though.
It's all good. Like, I really do. I think that you are a cool ex. I think you're a cool girl.
Thank you.
I appreciate the slut walk because everybody, I think the guys always pick sides of, you know, who can be more sexy or who, you know, guys are just promiscuous. They really are. They do a lot. You know, y'all have an Audi. You know, we have an Innie. We look at things differently. Mm-hmm. And I think those are the facts. But if a girl has one too many boyfriends that they feel like is too many, then it'd be like, oh, yeah, you a hoe, you a slut, and all of this. But you can have 50 girlfriends and then plus 3 more while we're dating.
Well, that's almost why I kind of OD on Instagram on purpose. To prove
mean?
A point.
You
know what I'm saying?
What you mean?
I just say crazy shit on Instagram just to prove a point. Like, I'm extra hoish on Instagram to, like, prove a point.
So you're not hoish in real life?
I'm in a committed relationship. I mean, if you look at my history, I always have been.
Yeah.
I had some one-offs, of course, but... Maybe we all have. I mean, yeah, for the most part, I do like monogamy.
That's... So it's not, and the slut walk ultimately isn't related to being...
Well, I can call you a slut, but I don't really know your sexual history. I'm just projecting negativity onto you because I'm intimidated by your beauty or your success. So, like, that's what people do on social media. They'll be like, you're a slut, you're a whore, if you just post a pretty picture. They really don't know who you slept with.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
So it's like, just embrace the word slut. It's like, it really doesn't mean anything. It's just like a derogatory word that, you know, insecure people use on people.
So what if you had a daughter and they said, and she was upset about that, about people calling her slut? What would be your advice?
I would tell her to be like so.
You tell her to be like so?
Yeah.
What? So what?
So what?
So what?
Why would they call her a hoe, right?
Yeah.
A few reasons. Either she slept with somebody.
That they like.
Either she got fingered or made out with somebody. I'm being honest. You talk about daughter. I'm thinking high school, right?
So facts.
Okay, that's where most of the bullying starts. You know, she got caught up, you know, a side street making out with a boy and trying to be secretive. I mean, it doesn't make you
and
a
jealousy.
Whore. Yeah, it's just, and I've done it. I'm a former slut shamer. When I was young, I would like boys and they would like other girls and I would try to say bad things about the girls
to
so they
the
would like me, you know? It's just a part of growing up, but God blessed me with sons and now it's, what I have to do is teach my sons about consent, about respecting women, about knowing what no actually means.
And boundaries.
And boundaries. So.
Yeah. Shout out to OC Genesis. OC Genesis, when somebody says no, they
no.
don't like it. It means no, goddammit. Now that's dumb. Okay,
can I just say something about OC Genesis?
What? Everybody says he's so nice.
He's
I can't
such
believe
a great guy, Keyshia. He was on my talk show and I had my talk show.
Yeah.
And he did my slut walk. I mean, he headlined my slut walk for free. I mean, he's just a ball of sunshine. You should give him a chance. He's a great guy.
Like a ball of sunshine.
And you know what? And he did that because. He loves your music.
He put me on the ugly sweater.
I know.
You know, my boyfriend had to tell me it was an ugly sweater. I didn't even know it was an ugly sweater. Now we got problems.
He's a great guy.
I was like,
Keyshia.
So I didn't think it was a problem. He had me on the sweatshirt. He was like, babe, it was an ugly sweater party. I was like,
he's literally, but honestly, he's literally one of my favorite people.
This one went over my head. I didn't know.
Ugly sweaters are cute, though.
I mean, I was bald. I tried to wear my hair blonde like you, Amber. It didn't work, Amber.
You gotta come over. I'll hook you up.
Okay. Amber gonna give me the bald look. Okay, mm-hmm. Amber, you gonna give me the bald look?
I got
look.
You.
Okay, cool.